This chapter will give you an introduction to the various electronic chart display systems offered to the maritime industry, giving their advantages and disadvantages as seen from a navigator's point of view. The IMO accepted definition of an electronic chart display equipment, abbreviated ECDIE, is the display equipment that processes and indicates necessary information compiled in ENC and other information to assist in safe navigation. The IMO accepted definition of an electronic chart display system, abbreviated ECDIS, is a system that displays hydrographic information which may be combined with information provided by electronic position fixing systems, GPS, radar, etc., to assist in the safe navigation of the vessel. An ECDIS consists of the electronic navigational chart as a data file and the electronic chart display equipment hardware. This is the definition of a system which shows or integrates on one display where we earlier have separated it into three different places on the bridge of a ship, the chart, the position, and the radar. In addition, ECDIS is a system which can also store and use information from lists of lights, sailing directions, tide tables, etc., together with the chart. That is the reason why IHO defines ECDIS as Electronic Chart Display and Information System. ECS is a generic term for equipment which displays electronic charts, but which does not and will not satisfy the SOLAS convention. ECS cannot be used as a substitute for official paper charts, and an up-to-date paper chart must therefore be available. Examples of ECS include radar systems incorporating video maps, standalone video plotters, and all current commercial raster chart and vector chart display systems. IMO made the decision in June 98 that raster chart display systems, RCDS, should be operated together with an appropriate folio of up-to-date paper charts. Later discussions between IMO and IHO led to the conclusion that raster charts should be viewed as a simplified mode for ECDIS equipment. The raster chart standard should form a part of the ECDIS performance standards where it would logically fit. A raster chart should only be used when a vector type chart required for normal ECDIS operation is not available. Some of the most obvious advantages of ECDIS are: at any time, it shows the ship's position on the chart, in true motion, with or without radar overlay and ARPA integration, in one display. It only uses the chart information necessary for safe navigation. It updates the chart by satellite and thereby increases the speed of updating. Automatic chart updating. Simple voyage planning. Anti-grounding warning. Tide-corrected depth contour. Black box possibility, storing the ship's navigation data for a certain period. Gives detailed information about lights, buoys, beacons, etc. by pointing on the chart symbol. Vary the chart scale according to navigation conditions. Vary the chart colors depending on day or night navigation. Show the ship in true size in narrow and difficult areas and conditions. Advantages of vector charts are many. Here are some. Chart information is stored in layers. Users may customize chart displays to suit the particular needs of their vessels. The chart data is seamless. It is possible to zoom in without distorting the charted data. It is possible to select a safety depth and a safety contour. Alarms or indications can be given when own ship is expected to cross safety contour or to enter a specified area. It is possible to interrogate charted objects for further information. File sizes are up to 10 times smaller for vector charts than for raster charts. Vector charts can generally be displayed more quickly than raster charts. A larger color palette is available for vector charts than for paper or raster charts. Objects may be shown using different symbols to those used on paper or raster charts. Charts may be rotated to any angle, course up referenced. Charts may be shared with other equipment, such as radar and ARPA. The main disadvantages of vector charts are: vector charts are technically far more complex than raster charts. Vector charts take longer and cost more to produce than raster charts. Significant worldwide coverage will not be provided by official vector charts for many years. Training in the use of vector charts is likely to be longer and more costly than that for raster charts. It is significantly more difficult to ensure the quality and integrity of the displayed vector data. The main advantages of raster charts are: they are direct and exact copies of existing paper charts. They use the same familiar colors and symbols as paper charts. Their contents are as comprehensive, accurate, and reliable as those of paper charts. It is not possible for users to inadvertently omit significant navigational information from the chart display. As the raster charts are produced from components used in the production of paper charts, both versions can be kept in step. Raster charts are simpler and easier to produce and update than official IHO-compliant vector charts. It is much easier to ensure the quality and integrity of the displayed data. They cost less to produce. Officially produced raster charts are widely available. For example, ARCS can now provide worldwide coverage. Information from other nautical publications may be displayed in the same raster format. With the addition of vector overlays and suitable software, it is possible to use raster charts for all the standard navigational tasks normally carried out with paper charts, and to emulate some of the functions of ECDIS. Some of the disadvantages of raster charts are: the display cannot be customized. When raster charts are overlaid with other information, the display may appear cluttered. Raster charts cannot directly provide alarms or indications to show that own ship is expected to cross a safety contour or to enter a specified area. Raster charts cannot be interrogated without some form of additional database with a common reference system. Raster charts cannot be sensibly rotated to head up or other orientations. Raster charts have larger memory requirements than vector charts. The IMO performance standards for ECDIS were developed in cooperation with the International Hydrographic Organization, IHO, and the International Electrotechnical Commission, IEC. The IHO has developed complementary recommendations on electronic navigation charts, which standardize the database and the content, structure, and format of the information provided and displayed. The IEC is developing the methods of testing an ECDIS so it meets the requirements from IMO and IEC.